church family. As I'm reflecting on Easter this year, it will be a very different Easter. Not only will it be the first time I'm not at worship in 50 years of my life, but also the first time that my husband and I won't share Easter with any of our children. Easter has always been an exciting time. I love decorating Easter eggs. I love putting Easter baskets together for the kids, doing Easter egg hunts and candy and shopping for new clothes, and of course having pictures in those new clothes. We have kind of a, you know, first day of school always picture and an Easter picture. So while I can think of this Easter maybe as a little bit of a lonely time, I also started thinking about, okay, well, what would be the new beginnings that I see? Because there are a lot. And once I started thinking about it, I got pretty excited. So moving to Georgia as a new beginning, I have a new beginning with my sister and brother who and their families who I've never lived close to my entire adult life. I thought about joking. I've always joked when I've worked someplace. I don't know what I want to be when I grow up. But I found what I want to be when I grow up, and it's this job as director of student ministries here at this church. That's pretty exciting that I feel like God's created me to do this job. A new beginning for our children. Since last Easter, our daughter has graduated with her master's degree and has her own apartment. Both of our sons have married beautiful women that they adore, and that's ultimately what we want for them. For those new beginnings for them. And a new beginning and a new chapter for all of us is that we have a new granddaughter. And what an incredible blessing and new beginning that is. No, we may not be sharing a worship service. We may not have Easter baskets or Cadbury cream eggs together. A big meal or family photos, but the real gift is what Jesus gave to us. The new beginning he gives us each day because he died and he rose again. That resurrection is why we have Easter. So I'm asking Jesus to help me see him this year. With everything stripped away, we can, in this non-traditional Easter, we can really take a time to focus on Jesus without those other things. Traditions are great, don't get me wrong. But just really being able to focus on Jesus and what the new beginning and new life that he gives to us. So can I encourage you today, sometime during this non-traditional Holy Week, to ask Jesus to show himself to you in a new and fresh way. I hope you and your family have a very blessed Easter.